It's a pretty hot bushveld day today, and there's a lot of animal and bird vocal activity going on. Just listen. Baboon. Emerald-spotted wood dove. And Birchall's cuckoo. But there's a constant tuk, 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 tuk bird going on all the time. Hear it in the background. Actually, two of them. It's two yellow-fronted tinkerbirds. There are four types of tinkerbirds in southern Africa. They're little birds about the size of a canary. The yellow-fronted, with a splash of yellow on his forehead from the central parts. The red-fronted, with a splash of red on his forehead, generally from the coastal regions of the Eastern Cape and Natal. Then there's the golden-rimmed, that has a black hood, generally from the coastal regions of northern Natal and Mozambique. But alas, there's an endangered green tinkerbird. He's greenish all over and has rarely been spotted recently and comes from northern Mozambique. This rare bird was first identified in Tanzania in 1884. All these tinkerbirds are quite similar in size, and apart from the green tinkerbird, markings are similar. They are the smallest in the barbet family. Now, when tinkerbirds are heard, they're often hard to see. They are also kind of ventriloquists. Yes, they throw their voices to sound where they are not located. On a hot day like this, they love to call. And the Zulus call them unukatilanga, the one that rides with the sun. What a beautiful connotation. All tinkerbird calls are similar in that they sound like someone hammering on a tin or a metal object with a small hammer, like me with my knife on my water bottle. The red-fronted fellow's call is faster and goes on longer than his yellow-fronted cousin, the one we are hearing now. The golden rump's call is similar, but he only does about five or six tooks at a time with a gap in between. The green, when heard, was similar, but ended with a churr. These birds eat mostly insects and berries, and are particularly fond of mistletoe berries. They are actually known as mistletoe distributors. Now, the mistletoe has an interesting history. It is, as we know, a plant that grows on another plant, a parasite. It gets its name from an ancient Anglo-Saxon word mistel, meaning droppings, and tum, meaning branch, later corrupted to toe, mistletoe. Actually, Afrikaans for droppings is mist. The mistletoe is associated with Christmas and romance. Kiss under the mistletoe. This comes from the fact that ancient herbalists used to make love potions out of the berries, the seeds of which are extremely sticky. Nature makes them that way so that they can stick to branches and tree trunks to germinate in bird droppings or regurgitated food, that is, food that is brought up after eating and spat out. That's what the yellow-fronted tinkerbird does. Spits out the seeds, wipes his sticky beak onto branches of trees, and mistletoe grows from there. As far back as Roman times, mistletoe seeds were used to make birdlime, a sticky substance put on branches to catch birds when they land on it, later to be eaten or put in cages. This is a very cruel practice and is illegal in many countries. The Romans got the idea of using birdlime from the mistle thrushes, who love mistletoe berries. They would perch on branches that were full of their own droppings and get stuck. There was a Roman saying, "The mistle thrush catches itself." Incidentally, in our region, there is only one thrush that I have seen eating berries, and that's the olive thrush. But nothing is impossible with our feathered companions. Now, all tinkerbirds nest in very small holes in trees. The entry hole is so small, it would be hard to place two fingers into it. They lay two to three white eggs. As I said, The tinker bird's call is like someone hitting a metal object with a small hammer, you know. Well, long ago in Europe, there were no repair people like there are today. There was, however, a wandering gypsy man called a tinker who roamed the streets with a little tool bag over his shoulder. Housewives used to call him to repair kitchen utensils specially, and these housewives really believed in his skills and relied on him to fix their damaged kitchen wares. Now that's how the tinker bird got its name. I think I'll use the yellow-fronted fellow to help me with this song called The Good Old Tinker. He keeps perfect time.